Lecture 3. The consciousnesses of sentient beings are arising and ceasing moment by moment. Take the visual consciousness, for example, during the interaction between the visible form and the visual faculty in every moment. Both the visible form and the visual faculty are changing, and the visual object generated by the perception is also changing. Therefore, visual objects are changing moment by moment, just like dreams. Hence, we know that our visual consciousness has never seen something that remains the same between two moments. By inference, this is also true for our ear, nose, tongue, and body consciousnesses. While the five dusts are interacting with the five sense faculties moment by moment, the perception is also generating different sense objects moment by moment, namely the visual, auditory, olfactory, gustatory, and tactile objects. The five sense objects are also changing moment by moment. A consciousness corresponds to an object and perceives the object as it is. For example, when we listen to a song, while the sound is arising and ceasing moment by moment, our ear consciousness is also perceiving it moment by moment. The first five consciousnesses perceive the five sense objects faithfully and impartially in this way. However, due to ignorance and karma, this perception is mixed with illusions, like seeing the world through coloured glasses. Similarly, due to ignorance and karma, the first five consciousnesses perceive the world with illusions. Since the items in a continuum share similar shapes, colours, and textures between consecutive moments, as ordinary beings, our first five consciousnesses can't directly discern their momentary changes, but regard the different moments as one. Therefore, the illusion that this is permanent arises. First, since the consecutive moments are similar, we regard them as one. Secondly, since we regard the consecutive moments as one, we consider the continuum permanent. In addition, our knowledge of the world is completely from the sixth consciousness. However, the data for our sixth consciousness's knowledge completely comes from the first five consciousnesses. While the first five consciousnesses perceiving the five sense objects is like people with eye disease seeing things, what they see is not the reality. On top of that, as ordinary beings, our sixth consciousness can't directly perceive the momentary changes of things, but we are very confident about its perception. In fact, since the first five consciousnesses can't properly discern, the sixth consciousness can't perceive correctly and faithfully. When the sixth consciousness perceives things, it tends to think, this is eternal, this is solid, this is unchanging. That person is still the same, that mountain is still the same. And once it discriminates, the three poisons of greed, anger, and ignorance arise, driving people to continually create karma with their body, speech, and mind. Being unaware that things are momentary and meaningless, humans are trapped in the ignorance of attachment to permanence. For countless kalpas, they have been attached like this, exhausted pursuing worldly matters. If someone craves for fame, wealth, and material comforts, he will arouse intense greed. If he is hindered in obtaining these things, he will arouse intense anger. In short, because we ordinary beings cling to the significance of momentary things, the afflictions of pride, jealousy, competition, disappointment, etc., arise constantly like a waterfall. Day by day, we are accumulating negative karma, which leads to great suffering in the lower realms. But don't seek liberation from the three types of suffering. If we learn from enlightened beings and rediscover everything, then after a long period of learning, contemplating, practicing, and realizing, we can realize the reality of things in the world and the truths they contain. Then the sixth consciousness can transform into discriminating wisdom, which can measure everything objectively and impartially, leading us to be away from confusion and head towards enlightenment. Regarding all conditioned things, the discriminating wisdom is constantly aware that they are momentary and meaningless. From then on, the mind reawakens. The wise no longer cling to conditioned things, but are fully devoted to be free from the three kinds of suffering and transcending samsara. In this way, all the turmoils in the world will come to an end. Now, we should understand that since the mind is changing moment by moment, all things that arise out of it are momentary and impermanent. Therefore, all things in front of us have reached unity in terms of being momentary. Even the Buddha's physical body, perceived by our conceptual mind, is also an impermanent image. Why? Because even the Buddha's physical body is an image that appears in the conceptual mind of sentient beings. How can there be any permanence? Therefore, even Sambhogakaya and Nirmanakaya Buddhas are not true Buddhas. Everything that has a form is momentary and impermanent. Usually, the sages tell us that only the Dharmakaya is the true Buddha. However, the Dharmakaya is formless, intangible, and inconceivable. Therefore, don't expect to see the Dharmakaya, as it's invisible. If you happen to see an image of a Buddha or a Bodhisattva during practice, don't be too excited and think that you have really seen the Buddha. What you see is merely an illusory image of Buddha, which may be created by Mara or manifested by Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. It's uncertain. When causes and conditions combine, things arise. When causes and conditions disappear, they cease. We can summarize it into two points. Number one, causality can only be established on momentary things. If something is permanent, it can't establish causality. Only momentary things can. Number two, everything we perceive is dependent, arising in nature from the beginning to the end. When causes and conditions combine, we conceptualize it as a phenomenon. But in reality, it has never arisen or ceased. We just give it a label, a name, but actually it doesn't exist. When the causes and conditions disappear, as it lacks inherent existence by nature, there is no disappearance of it. Okay, that's all for this lecture.